Hi, I'm Tyler Harden, Executive Vice President at TTM Fleet Solutions. First off, thank you for attending FreightWaves Live at home. Now, I'd like to demo for you the client portal and the 2.0 Fleet Assist client portal, brand new, and it's coming to you from Josh Dill, our Director of Business Integrations. He's going to show it to you now.
Hi, everybody. Josh Dill here, going to give you a quick demo of our new customer portal. So once you log into the system using your credentials, this is your main dashboard that you'll see. So we'll start on the left. You know, you have your, you can navigate through your dashboard, your call management, your accounting, which shows you, you know, what's not been invoiced, what's been invoiced and unpaid, and what's been invoicing specific details on cost, provider details, and metrics. You got your profile, so you can come in here and change your company details, show your national accounts, upload your assets and driver identification, even upload your users in different hierarchies, and even your repair stances and protocols. We also have a demo system that you can play in and learn. It's like a little sandbox, shows you the life of an event and what happens all the way through an event and how it shows in the system. We also have an analytics tab that shows you your customer reporting. So this is based off how we set up your hierarchy, and it's we do even go down to the 9 code for VMRS all the way down to the part. So we have a very robust reporting system that can show you this specific information for each event. So at the top of the dashboard, you can see your hierarchy, which we can set up as where your assets are domiciled, your cost centers, or even specific protocols and repair stances for different types of assets. If we scroll down, you know, you'll see your live case management that you can drill into, and we'll show more on this in a second. You even have a little metrics tab over here that you can scroll and, you know, say how many events are entered, ETA time, ETA compliance, ATC compliance. And then as well as your new case management button here, which you can drop a call into the system like it's live. So let's go ahead and start this. Once we load your asset number, once we load your assets, we can automatically populate all your asset information during this intake. So it automatically populates year, make, caller, model, VIN number. You'll see in the background here that these are all the providers that we have in the location, and depending on what service and subservice we select and how we answer these questions going forward, it will sort out different providers, not only qualify the right provider, but qualify the service and subservice. So let's continue and go ahead and select service now. This is where you select the service. You'll see more grayed out boxes over here, which are more specialty products that we offer. Let's go ahead and set up a tow, and let's do it as a heavy duty tow. Then we'll do this tractor only. So this is just like a Google search. So you can come in here and say, hey, this is what, you know, I'm at the TA here. Select next. And you see it drops the truck at the right location. So from here, you'll enter your breakdown notes. If you have a purchase number or reference number that you require before call entry, you can enter it here. If you want us to reach out to the driver, you can hit yes and enter this driver information here. And then, like I said, these questions are dynamic. So not only does it qualify what, when, and how we service these, but also the service providers that we select. Let's go ahead and answer these. And that is it. So this automatically dropped the call in our system. You can see we have 79 vendors in the area that can service this. You'll submit for external handling. So from there, boom, it drops it in as a pending call. And as this call proceeds, it will go into these different buckets showing the life cycle of what's happening. Hey, it's pending on our board, we're actively dispatching it, it's on site all the way to it's completing it, and we're reviewing the case. So let's go ahead and you can either come in here and hit the I and go into the work order, or you can also hit this here and look at what's going on. So it gives you a little information about what's going on, what's happening. View the details, you know, it gives you a little summary of what the cost is. Down here, you got the metrics of when it started, when it was entered, when it was dispatched, when the initial ETA was. In the repair order details, you can see we got this VMRS coded, it shows the estimated SRT costing. Also, you have full access to all notes that we put in the system. So status changes, any kind of text that we send out to the driver or update that we get, you have full access, and you can even include a note here to communicate with our team. Also, in the view attachments, you can see all emails that we've sent out, as well as any attachments that we have. So provider invoices, pictures of tires, pictures of what's going on, anything that may be happening, we can include that here, and you have full access to it. So that's been a quick review of our new customer portal. Hope this has been helpful, and it was worth your time. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Josh. Well, now you guys know what most carrier support groups already know, and how easy it is to manage unexpected maintenance with Fleet Assist 2.0. Setup is very easy. Sign up is simple. Reach out to us. You can reach out to us at ttnfleetsolutions.com or simply send us an email at sales@ttnfs.com. Until then, stay safe out there, and let's keep these trucks moving. Thanks.